Hello, sports fans. Larry Allen here, along with Scott Surratt, the head football coach and athletic director at Carthage High School. No game last week, so we're going to get right into talking about the Pleasant Grove Hawks. Pleasant Grove coming in with a record of 4-1, and Josh Gibson has really turned things around up there. Longtime school known for baseball. In fact, they had either six or seven teams in a row that went to the state tournament in Austin. Josh Gibson in his fourth year, 6-5 the first year, 6-7 and 16, and then wow, 16-0 last year, won the state championship beating West Orange 41-21, and they're 4-1 this year. So Scott, going from 6 wins in 1 year to 16 the next, that's pretty good, isn't it?
It is good. Josh done a phenomenal job. There's no question about it. And, they should be 5-0 this year. They turned the ball over five times against Gladewater, and I think had over 200 yards more than Gladewater. So he just played a bad game with the turnovers. And Gladewater's pretty good, too. So he had a very good football team. He does a phenomenal job coaching he and his staff, and they've really turned it around, and it's going to be an exciting game.
All right. Tell us some of their players.
Well, first of all, on offense, you got to go with number 10, the quarterback. He's a great player. He throws it very well. They are different in their wing T, slot T, whatever you want to call it. They do like to throw the ball, and he's a phenomenal thrower. He'd be a great player in any system, whether it's spread or whatever. And then they got two good running backs, number 33 and 2. They run the ball very, very hard, and 2 can really, really run very fast. And 6 is a good player, too. He's a running back. He's a sophomore. And then, the tight end, number 40, Landon Jackson, comes over and plays some tight end. And then their number one target is number 3, the Cobb kid. He's really fast and does a good job for him, too.
All right. We want to get your additional comments on Landon Jackson. He's going to play on defense in college. There's no doubt about that. And he has 9 Division I offers so far. Got Texas just a couple of weeks ago. So he's got Texas, he's got A&M, he's got Baylor, he's got Texas Tech among those 9 offers. And 6'5", I've seen him listed at 212. Another one listed him at 222. So he's a little bit taller, just slightly, perhaps a little bit heavier than our Quentin Owens and Quantarius Brown and Desmond Hicks, but obviously he is quite a player, had some great stats as a freshman. So question would be this: is he going to be lining up, in your opinion, for the most part on the side of JT Romero or on the side of Ty Keats Crawford?
Oh, I don't know. I think they'll move him around. We're prepared for him to move around, and I think it, for most part, he has been our offensive right on tape, but he has moved around. So I think he'll move around. And he's a great player, and he's the one that we've got to block, or we'll be in trouble because he rushes the passer very well, and he stopped. He has a lot of tackles for loss, and then he's got a lot of sacks. I think he had 10 or 12 last year, I believe, as a freshman, and he's got a great start to this year. And he's just a great player, and we've got to control him. We can't let him have a field day on us. But they have a lot of good players behind him too. So it's very challenging. But I think we'll be ready for the challenge.
About how many plays does he go on offense at tight end?
He'll go over quite a bit. He'll go over quite a bit. And, he's a defense every down, and I would say 50% of the time he's on offense, and so. He's in good shape. He's a good player. I coached his uncle at Texas High. So.
All right. Now, get your comments on this, a couple of stats. So far this year, 70% of their total yardage is on the ground, 70-30. 70 on the ground, 30 through the air, versus our more balanced attack. We're 44% on the ground, 56 through the air. You expect them to want to stay in this ball game, 70% on the ground?
I do. We do. And all that percentage change, if we can stop the run or control the run, and then I think the percentage will go up in the passing game. I think if we can't control the run, the percentage may go up in the run game. It depends on how we are stopping the run. And if we can make them one-dimensional and throw the ball more, we like our chances better.
You know, when I've come out to practice, I've seen Luis Piedra and Alberto Garcia both hit 50-yard field goals. Very seldom that we play someone with as strong a leg as our two guys, but from what I've heard, they've got a pretty good kicker, too.
He's a great kicker. He's left-footed, and, he's hit a 47-yarder, and I believe against Henderson, but whoever he's against, he's probably made five or six field goals already, and I don't think he's missed one. I don't think I've seen him miss one, and he's got plenty of leg. The 47-yarder would probably been good from 55. So he's a good kicker. He can sky kick. He can deep kick. He can put it where he wants to.
Now, of course, we've seen both of our guys kick it, extra points and kickoffs. Do they mainly go with that one kicker?
Yeah, he's our guy. He's really good at what he does, and I haven't seen another kicker. So, hopefully he's the best one, because they bring another one in, he's special. But I hope he don't get to kick too much. I hope he don't score, have a field day scoring, and then he's kicking all night, or down there close kicking extra points or field goals. And, yeah, we'd like to keep him off the field as much as we can.
Now, I'm pretty certain this is the first time in your 12 years here that we, as a defending state champion, have played another defending state champion. Is this the first time that in your 12 years that we've played a defending state champion, whether we were defending or not?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure on that.
Okay.
I know we have played some guys that played for the championship. I'm not sure if we played defending state championship or not.
Okay. And incidentally, a little sideline here. I noticed a report from Dave Campbell. Evidently, they may estimate who's going to be in the state finals after every week. And right now, they're estimating in Division One it'll be Carthage and La Vega, and in Division Two, Lorena and West Orange Stark. All right. So Pleasant Grove is the opposition this week. We've had the end of the 6 weeks. How'd we come out?
Didn't lose anybody. We're in really good shape.
Good going. Now the freshman team, I believe, so far is undefeated. JV has only lost one. That was by 1 point.
Oh, he did. Well, he had a heartbreak loss to Gilmer, and on the last play they scored. Well, for about 7 seconds or so they scored, and then they went for the win and made the 2-point conversion. I think we got to beat 36-35.
Mm-hmm.
But, we were down 21-0, I believe, in that game, and we fought back, and then we took the lead and just couldn't hold on at the end.
What are you seeing from that JV team?
We've got, I think, 6 or 7 sophomores up, and so I think it's a good group, and they're getting better as they go, just like hopefully all our groups are. And so we're excited about how they play. And, Pleasant Grove, I heard their JV's really good, so we'll see how we can play up there.
And there's one young man that got into the game in the second half against Gilmer, and I thought ran well. And I cannot remember his name. I intended to look it up. Number 34 was in the second half. Could his name be Jaden Thomas? Is that right? That doesn't ring a bell, huh? Okay. All right. Well.
Oh, you're talking about varsity.
Oh, yes, varsity.
Yes, I still listen to Jaden Thomas. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Talk to us about him. He looked pretty good.
He's a junior, and he's gained a lot of weight since last year, and he's getting stronger, and he's getting faster, and. We're expecting big things out of him. And he cramped up so bad last week because he ran it so hard, and he had to go get an IV at the emergency room. But great kid.
Uh-huh.
And, he may get some carries.
All right. Any final words? This should be a big homecoming crowd. This ought to be a good one. You can't beat it. Two defending state champions, number one against number four.
Yeah, it's very exciting. It's going to be a great atmosphere, obviously, and a lot of people, this may be the only game they see just because of coming back for reunions or whatnot. And so we're excited to play at home. We hadn't been at home in a while.
Mm-hmm.
Now we got 4 out of 6 games at home. So mm-hmm. This thing is set up very well for us. Now we just got to play really good football for home fans and the homecoming crowd.
And the health of the team.
I think we're very good health. Hunter Hill's very questionable where he'll go. Other than that, everybody's going to go, and for sure. So you can't ask more than that after 4 games, and
mm-hmm.
We have no excuses.
All right, very good. Those are the words of head coach Scott Surratt. Carthage Bulldogs ranked number 1 in the state in Class 4A, and Pleasant Grove Hawks ranked number 4 in the state. This should be a great one. Hope you can be there. at Bulldog Stadium for the 7:30 kickoff. If you can't, we'll be on the air 7 o'clock with a look at the starting lineups. For Coach Scott Surratt, I'm Larry Allen. Have a great weekend, everyone.